Hi guys, and welcome to BrainSnacks. My name is Clara, and in this channel I would like to share my fascination about science and technology. The first episode is about the discovery of Neptune. There are just a few places on Earth from where a planet was discovered. Recently, I found out that I used to live close to the discovery location of Neptune. Neptune was discovered in 1846 by the German astronomer Johann Galle after the French mathematician Urbain Le Verrier calculated where to find it. Let's see what's left of the observatory today. Now I'm standing close to the exact location where Johann Galle looked at the night sky through his telescope. Right behind me, that's the Jewish Museum, and this building already existed at the time of the Berlin Observatory. Unfortunately, of the observatory itself, there's nothing left today, except for an information panel with the ground plan and explaining that on the wall of the observatory, there used to be a reference benchmark for the sea level. This is how the Star Observatory looked at the time when Neptune was discovered. Here we have the astronomer Johann Galle, and the mathematician Urbain Le Verrier. But I think that everyone should know that from here a planet was discovered. We should put a flag here. But wait, didn't I bring one? But before we find out how this actually happened, here are some facts about the planet. Neptune is the farthest known planet from the Sun in our solar system. It is the fourth largest planet by diameter after Uranus, Saturn, and Jupiter. Neptune is 17 times as massive as Earth, and 58 Earth volumes could fit in it. Its average distance from the Sun is 4.5 million kilometers. One Neptune day is 16.1 hours, and one Neptune year, so the time that Neptune needs for a whole orbit around the Sun, is 164.8 years on Earth. This is NASA's spacecraft Voyager 2, the only spacecraft that visited Neptune and took close pictures of it and its satellites. Neptune has 14 known moons. Triton, its biggest moon, has some very interesting characteristics. Its orbit goes in the opposite direction of the orbit of its planet. This is called a retrograde orbit. Moreover, the orbit is inclined relative to Neptune's equator, which suggests that Triton did not form in the orbit around Neptune, but was gravitationally captured by it. But how did the mathematician and the astronomer discover the planet? Well, long before they did, already other astronomers, like Galileo Galilei, had seen Neptune through a telescope. But they didn't identify it as a planet. The actual discovery started with another planet, Uranus. In 1846, it was known that Uranus, the closest planet to Neptune, had irregularities in its orbit around the Sun. The theory to explain this of Urbain Le Verrier was that there had to be another planet farther out in the solar system that influenced Uranus gravitationally. With the data of Uranus' orbit, he calculated where to find this unknown planet. Then he informed Johann Galle in Berlin, who discovered Neptune within 1 degree of its theoretically calculated position. This makes Neptune a planet that first had been theoretically predicted and then had been actually discovered. Isn't that cool? Thank you very much for watching, and if you liked it, please hit the Neptunian subscribe button. This was Claire from BrainSnacks, and I hope to see you again next time. Bye bye!